What's going on, people? So last night, went to a little local wrestling thing, right? So there's Virginia Championship Wrestling, VCW, right? Super creative name, by the way. So whoever thought that up, wow. Anyway, so I went over there, right? Because Christopher Daniels was going to be there. Originally, it was supposed to be Jay Lethal, but some things came up, so we had to go do AEW stuff. So they slipped in Christopher Daniels, which to me was kind of an upgrade. Nothing against the other dude, but I've been following him since he came to Missouri on some very small tour back in like 98 or something. Following loosely, you know, not like day to day seeing what he's up to. But anyway, so I figured let me go out and do that, right? Get to meet the guy again and all that good stuff. And it turned out that like the actual show was really good from top to bottom. So you might be asking yourself though, like, what does that have to do with like what we're here to talk about? Nothing at all, like not even a little bit, right? Super unrelated. But I figured I'd bring it up because it's a thing that I'm thinking about right now. I'm also thinking about these shoes, but more so the entertainment of last evening. Which was in a, what was it, in a church? A Masonic temple? I don't know if that's the same thing as a church, but it felt like it. Either way, so let's go ahead and look at these things. So, looking at the side of the box, there's that there for the people that care to see it. So this right here, right, you've seen these before, probably because they are not new, not at all. But here's the thing, right, when they came out the first time, I remember kind of being into them, but it might have just been that the timing was bad, so maybe that's why I didn't go for them or something, or maybe I did and it just didn't work out. I honestly don't remember, I just know that I didn't get them, right? But they brought them back a couple weekends ago, like when my mom was up here for the AEW show, whatever week that was, right? Because I got the little alert thing on my phone, and it's like, oh, hey, Krusty Burgers. And I was like, all right, cool. So I went into like the confirm thing to go and put my little entry in there, or my purchase, because they were wide open for 48 hours. And they were like, you know, like the app was having some problems. So I closed it, went back into it, couldn't find them. And I was like, well, that's stupid, right? So I tried a couple times, and I was like, you know what? Forget it, I'm just gonna move on. And then like an hour or two later or something, they sent an email out with it, which had like an actual link in there. So then I was able to get them. So that was pretty cool, you know? I kind of wish more places would do that, but hey, it is what it is. And in a way, it's good that not a lot of people do that because then I'd be trying to buy more stuff and I don't think I need to buy more stuff. Anyways, there's the backstory. So now let's go ahead and talk about these right here. The Adidas ZX 10,000 Krusty Burger sneakers, right? Pretty sure that's it. Seems short when I said it, but whatever. So we'll start with this one, why not, right? Down there across the bottom, right? What you're looking at down there, from what I recall, kind of a standard sort of ZX outsole, but I do like the gum bottom and the colorful bits that they have on there. Super nice touch, right? And then, as you move on up here to the midsole and all that good stuff, not as fancy as the bottom was. You could just kind of white it out with a little bit of red towards the back end, but it's decent, you know? And so now, taking a look at the overall shoe and all that good stuff, which you've probably seen, like I said, many times before, there's not a whole lot to really say, but in a way, there's a lot of stuff happening at the same time, so it's kind of weird in that way. But we're going to get down in here, we're going to do the whole thing that I normally do, talk about all the stuff, give you some up-close pictures and whatnot, so then you can kind of make your own decision on what you really think of these, because maybe you're on the fence. Let me know how you feel at the end of the video or something, or don't, it's all the same. Down here around the toe box, right? So what you're gonna have down here is kind of like a canvas sort of material feel, kind of like what you see on like a lot of Vans type shoes. And that's gonna be like a theme across a lot of the shoes. So you'll know when you see it. Either way, so you got that in a beige sort of color. Above that, on the top of the toe box here, you got this nice mesh feel. It's very soft. I'm not sure how to really describe that, but if you can kind of look at it, you see what I'm talking about. And then down between those two, you have just a little bit of red suede going on. Well, actually, it feels more like felt, honestly. It looked like suede for a second. But anyways, you got that, right? And some thick black lines. Kind of gives it that cell-shaded appearance, like I said about the, what's the one with the drink? The Moe's, the Flaming Moe's, right? Like the whole Auto Modelista or the Borderlands sort of look. Yeah, that sort of thing is going on all across this. So anyways, moving back just a little bit from there. You got this brown piece kind of made to look like a hamburger bun, right, for obvious reasons. So you got the little yellow sesame seed style thing going on there. And then stepping back just a little bit past that, on the outside at the bottom, you have the pink felt type area, and it's got the plastic swoosh put on there, right? on the inside, you don't have that. You still have the same layout, just no logo. Did I say spoof? Anyway, no logo on the inside. So anyways, above that though, right, you've got the three stripes. Kind of reminds me of like one of those EQTs, or actually a lot of the EQTs, honestly. So these, it's going to be this very stiff feeling plastic type of thing, right? That's how it feels. It's not plastic, it's stitched, right? You can kind of tell that. But it feels like stiff plastic. It's kind of odd. Not so much like the upper part here that's holding down the laces, but still, you kind of might know what I'm saying. Anyways, moving on just a little bit further back here. So you got more of that same sort of brown like you had in the front area, just in the back area, and no little seeds on there. And then down here on the bottom piece, right, you've got this white plastic outlining for the heel cup type thing. And down there in the middle area on both sides, you have what is going to be basically like Krusty's hair, right? So you got that sort of green kind of color going on. Feels pretty nice, you know? So I do like that. And then as you look at the very back, obviously they have the full middle area going on there in the same sort of way with the Adidas logo, or one of the Adidas logos, I should say. And above that, you've got this slightly yellowish line going on, and that's going to be kind of a felt sort of feel. And then you have something that feels more like that sort of nylon mesh type thing as, that you saw in like the toe box area at the very top. So that about sums up all the stuff that's going on as far as that, right? So let's jump back over here to the lace. Actually, you know what? One more thing. So one thing I didn't quite mention because I kind of forgot. Down here where you have like these upper areas, right? It's not fully stitched down or anything. It's kind of like a dual layer thing, almost like a Presto, or not Presto, a Hirachi or something, right? So you got that going on. So you are going to have another layer there of the shoe. So in case you're curious how that looks or why it might have looked weird from certain angles, that's why. Because it's not all stitched down like that. Anyways, now back to these laces here, right? So first off, before I forget, you do have a second pair of laces here. So you got this black pair, right? And on the black pair, there's the little logo on there somewhere, probably like around the middle-ish or whatever. I don't know if that's also on the white pair or whatever, because I looked very briefly. When I mean briefly, I mean like half a second, you know, and I gave up super fast. But if you look also at the tips of the laces, they do say A to ZX series on all four of them. So nothing special about them too much. I do kind of like the black ones a little bit more, but I'm not much for lace swapping or whatever. I tend to just go with whatever's there when I get the shoe. So looks like I'll be doing these white laces for the rest of my life. Anyways, down here at the bottom, right? You have this here lace debris thing going on. This one, it's going to be blue, kind of like a sky blue with some white in there. And this other bag over here attached to the other shoe, you have a whole bunch of them. At least maybe like three different options or something like that. So six pieces, right? But either way, so you got some options there if you don't like the blue. And you have an option if you don't like the white. But anyway, so the laces here, they're pretty much just going to be like your standard flat laces. The one thing I will say is that they're very small and very thin, right? Almost feels like something you might see on like a dress shoe or something, but I don't really have a lot of dress shoes. I have like one. Well, no. I guess kind of I could say like that Ned Flanders shoe, I guess. But either way, very small, very thin laces, though they are very soft, so that's cool, right? And anyways, that's going to be it for that. Behind that on the tongue, you have the same material that you had down here on the upper, right? All along the upper part of the toe box. So it feels very soft. I do really like that. And then at the top of the tongue, finishing things off, you have the Adidas logo in the same coloring style that you saw on the back. So there's that. This time around, it's just going to be stitched on to this little thing that they have at the top. And that's about it. So let's jump onto the inside, get things done. So down on there, what you're seeing is basically like a yellowish sort of insole with Adidas and the Simpsons. And if you look towards the front end of that, you'll see the Krusty Burger thing and all that stuff. So if I can get these out, I'll show you like a good picture. If not, you're just going to have to take what you get. So there's that. And then you got just like the standard black sock liner stuff, you know, pretty well cushioned for like a shoe like this. You know what I'm saying? Nothing amazing, but it's pretty good. So there we go. We've covered all the outer things or whatever. So I'll hit you with some personal thoughts, then we'll do the sizing. That's how things work around here. But I think a lot of you already know that. Now, when I saw these the first time, I don't remember being like super crazy about them, but I did like them, right? It just, for whatever reason, it wasn't meant to be in that time. So I kind of wrote it off, honestly, because I tend to do that when I miss out on things. But when the opportunity came back around, I was like, okay, this is going to happen, especially since it's basically like get your order in the next little while, next 2 days, and you'll get them. Like, oh yeah, I was totally on board with that. So here we are, and I got them, and I did the unboxing on Instagram Live at some point, and I was looking at them. I was like, man, these are actually really nice. You know, I mean, it's not like mind-blowing or whatever, but I gotta say, like, as far as these Simpsons shoes go, like, they've all been really good. Where I'd rank this one overall, I'm not quite sure, but I will say that I'm definitely pleased with the full-on execution of it. I might still lean towards the Mo's as being my personal favorite of my collection, but these definitely hold their own against all the other ones, I would say. And it's a nice model in general, so it's one that I would like to have more of, and now I do, so that's pretty cool too. It's like a two birds stoned at once or something, you know what I'm saying? Something like that. But yeah, it's pretty solid, and for the price of whatever they cost, I think it's worth it, because I don't remember being upset at the price, so that's why I say it like that. But past that, I don't know what else to really say other than just that, you know, like I implied, I like the shoe. Isn't that really all you needed to hear, I guess? But but if I just said that, I wouldn't have enough time to show you all those pictures, so. Anyways, let's move on and talk about some sizing and get done so I can move on to those other shoes. I bought these in a 9.5, right? Because that's the size of shoes that I buy, because that's the size of my foot. It just kind of works out that way. And these fit pretty much like I expected them to. So that's going to be a true to size fit in my personal opinion, which is the same size also that I buy in like Nikes and like my Air Max, all that stuff, right? So that's what I'm going to suggest as far as the sizing goes. I will say that to me, these do feel like they feel a little roomy in some ways, not enough to like go down or whatever, but that's just how I feel, you know? So if you're kind of one of those people who kind of feels like I do, maybe get some thicker socks and that will help that out tremendously. Now, moving on past that, comfort-wise, these materials on the upper are feeling pretty nice. I don't want to make it sound like they're super premium or whatever because they're not, but they are feeling really good, you know? You have okay, and then you have like some things that are a couple steps above that. This is where these are. So that adds to like the overall comfort. And then when you talk about like the midsole, when you mix that in there, that, it's nothing amazing. And I know some people might think, oh, well, how's it compared to like Boost or Lightstrike? And that's not really like a fair comparison on account of those two things being like 30 years newer than this. So obviously they don't compare. But this, as far as just a normal all-day shoe to walk around in, I don't think there's going to be anybody complaining, right? I'm not saying it's the cream of the crop, definitely not. But it's definitely going to hold its own when you look at like just a shoe that you can wear all day and be okay with it. So take that for what it's worth and do whatever you want to do. Now past that, I don't think there's a whole lot else to say. Can't really speak on much of like the breathability of the shoe. It should be pretty good, but again, I haven't really worn these anywhere, so I'm not going to really say anything. But just going by what I saw, should be fine. But yeah, that's about it for me, I think. I'm going to just move on to the next video and stuff. So, from me to you, have a nice rest of your day or rest of your night, whatever it is, wherever you are. I'll be back, like I said, with some other videos and all that good stuff. And maybe you'll be back to watch them. I don't know. We'll see what happens. Later, people.